What's up, guys? Hanging here with the boys from Tune Up, and we're gonna talk about my very minimal gear here. Fire! This is the only bass I have on tour with me at the moment, or in general, because I sold my last one to get some other gear. It's a 50s style P bass, and I don't think I'd play any other bass really. I fucking love the thing. So, yeah, that's about it. The only weird thing about this one is the tuning pegs here are reversed, backwards, weird. Sometimes when I go to pick up an actual guitar, I accidentally turn it the wrong way, but that's about it. Nothing too crazy about this thing. I had a Fender Jazz Bass, but I think it was the main thing that I didn't like about it is just at the end of the neck up here, it just got really thin, and it was like, I don't know, I was just so used to this, you know? I like the heaviness of this bass, and yeah, I was just a little awkward, and we play a lot of stuff down on the first few frets, so yeah, I go with the P bass any day. Very minimal right now, as Tom told you guys. He lost a bunch of his pedals, and he was borrowing a couple of my pedals at the time. So, a couple of mine are missing as well. Thanks, China. But yeah, right now, just got the OCD full tone over here with some sweet overdrive. And that's about where all the tone comes from, besides this thing. It's got that nice low end in it. And the most important thing in the world, the tuner. And this is what powers it all. That's about it. It's pretty crazy, right? For one song, I use an effect, and it's a delay pedal. And we haven't been playing that song, so I don't need it with me right now. I mean, most of the time I have a couple more things on here. That's why this thing's way bigger than these three pedals put together. But just a Sans amp. Once in a while, I'll stomp on the, it's like a little fuzz pedal. And yeah, my noise suppressor. That's what's missing. That's what got lost in China. But yeah, that's about it. Nothing too crazy. So for the head and cab on this tour, what I'm using, also not my gear, but got the SVT 4 Pro here. We're renting from Navigator Backline Service for the whole tour. And Ampeg 8x10 right here. This is what I always use back at home. Any tour I'm on, that's usually what people have if we're sharing gear. But yeah, I love this head. I'm actually considering buying one because what I normally used was a SVT Classic, and we were using one on the store until it stopped working a few days ago. But yeah, that's probably my favorite head. But yeah, basically I always set them up the same way. You know, good amount of gain with the OCD. On top of it, I just go pretty high up on the bass and usually do a little mid scoop. That's really it. That's the basic gist of that. But yeah, I had an SVT Classic, and then when we flipped our van in the middle of Wyoming, we checked on the gear afterwards, and the only thing that stopped working was my SVT Classic. So I paid like $500 to fix it, and then 2 weeks later it stopped working on me again. So I said, all right, anybody want to buy this thing broken, because I'm over it, I'm going to get a solid state amp, and ended up going with the Galien Krueger. So that's what I've been using recently, you know, for touring the States. But every time we go overseas, we end up usually just sharing gear with, you know, Backline Service that we're renting from or whatever. So yeah, this is the rig. Uh, The first time I really played bass for any band ever was Stray from the Path. I was always a guitar player. Actually, my first tour with Stray was a fill-in tour. I was just filling in playing guitar, so it was me and Tom playing guitar. And, yeah. I mean, you know, I always messed around, picked up a bass once in a while at practice with other bands, you know, that I was in high school or middle school or whatever, but yeah, I was always a guitar player. Started playing guitar, I was probably 11, 12 years old, and yeah, my dad got me my first guitar Christmas one year, and yeah, just didn't stop from then on. He actually had a guitar sitting around the house before that, and I remember being really little, like 8 years old, and there was like three strings on the thing, because he didn't play it. It was just sitting around in a corner somewhere collecting dust. And me and my cousin, who was even younger than me at the time, we decided to put rubber bands where the string should be. And we tried playing that, and it clearly didn't work. The first bass I ever bought was that jazz bass. And some of the first guitars I had, one of them is hilarious. My dad got me a BC Rich Warlock, which at the time I was like, sick, okay, this is cool. You know, sixth grade. But, I had an Ibanez that I loved, I had a Jackson that I loved, and I don't even remember what happened to that thing, but I had a couple acoustics, and here's a funny story. I had a Mitchell acoustic, which is like, you know, you can get one for $250, and it sounds pretty damn close to a $1,000 acoustic. That's why I got the thing. I had it just sitting on a stand in my room, and I have two pugs, and one of them ran into my room and knocked it off the stand. Fat little pug named Ozzy. Knocked it right off, it landed on my nightstand and cracked the neck in half. That's how I woke up that morning, so that was cool. Since I was so young, when I was being influenced to play music in general, it was a lot of the music my dad was listening to at the time, and he's a big like classic rock guy, you know. So I was listening to like Zeppelin and stuff like that for a while, Guns N' Roses, whatever, and yeah. I'd say Dimebag is one of my huge influences though when it came to just picking up a guitar in the first place, because he was just sick as hell. But yeah, John Mayer, probably my favorite guitar player. I think the first show ever was with a band called Misled, and it had to be sixth grade, and it was a battle of the bands at a library on Long Island, and it was so shitty. And here's the funniest thing: Stray actually played that, old Stray back in the day, and they were all wearing suits. I'll never forget it. Corny as hell. If I wasn't playing music, I'd be trying to do what I'm doing right now as well, trying to make movies. Yeah, just directing a short film right now, just getting that done, and see where that takes me. But other than movies or music, I don't really know what the hell I'd be doing, you know. But yeah, if you want to check it out, the passagehorrorfilm.com.